They spend a little too much on jacking up diesels, my kind of people. They learn their ins and outs and ups and downs around mama's dinner table. Lovers of muddy river floats days ago, barefoot backwood homegrown souls. My kind of people, those damn good people. They're God-fearing, flag-waving, 90s country, 90s babies living a cold one at a time. And I'm proud to call them mine. My kind of people.
Morning, 8UP Nation. Kicking it off on Pursuit Channel, 8UP With It Outdoor Style. We're here with my boy Rodney Myers from Tree Rat, and we've had an awesome turkey season so far.
Sure have. We've still got a lot more to do.
We do, man. I think we've got like 25 birds down on camera so far for the show. Where are we at starting off, man? Episode 5 in Kansas with Brandon Grindle.
Yeah, they start out in a blind. They have a hen come in on first. It busts them and runs off, and then they have a couple more come in, and one of them's a bearded hen, which is legal in Kansas.
It is. It's 100% legal.
And they get the job done.
They do, and you know, they set up on this particular area, and it has a feeder in the camera. There's absolutely no corn in the feeder. They can feed out in Kansas during deer season. But this particular spot, man, the birds were just scratching on the acorns and just, you know, hammering it out. So Brandon and them set up in a blind. And he breaks a beak there on old bearded hen, man. That's some awesome footage. Y'all check out this next hunt with Brandon Grindle. You guys, I hope you enjoy it.
All right, guys, well, we are back at it. We're at a brand new spot with Matt and John from Lost Velvet Outdoors. We've had good luck this week so far. We've got 3 birds down in 4 days. Ron put down his last stack this morning. Excellent hunt. It's insane.
What a hunt.
Never seen anything like it. You guys will see it eventually, but we're in this setup. We've got agriculture fields on all sides of us. We've got a good creek that lies off behind us, so we're really sitting on like a peninsula. And we've got a good section of hardwoods here. They set the birds here. They've got trail cameras. They hunted it recently, so the birds are in here. I've got 1 tag left, and we've got this evening and tomorrow before we leave Kansas and head back home to Georgia.
You better get done tonight. I'm ready to go sleep.
We need a day of sleep, so we're gonna get it done. Y'all stay with us. We got a lot of action coming your way.
This is the bird. This is our 4th bird in 3 days up here in Kansas with Lost Velvet Outdoors. I can't even say this. This is the best way to end this trip. Tomorrow's our last day. It was supposed to rain. We were really hoping to get it done today. It's been slow. We had 1 hen come in. We kind of aggravated her. She took off on us. We gave it about an hour and Ryan hit that slate call. And I mean, in no time, we had 2 birds come rushing down that hill. I leaned back in my chair, sit there. Knew it was 2 hens, and that saying, I know Ryan's telling me to shoot the one on the left. And back in Georgia, this isn't possible for us. I mean, beard or no beard, you can't shoot a hen back at home. But so this is unbelievable. And a hen like this, this beard's pushing 7 inches. So this is extremely exciting. I just can't thank these guys enough. Matt and John Ashley, we're over here at John's property. Haven't hunted it all week. It's just been phenomenal. I've never seen this many birds. I just don't know what else to say. We're thankful. We've got some great birds on the ground. So y'all stay with us. We'll bring y'all some more action.
Closed captioning for 8 Up With It Outdoors is brought to you by Frog Talks.
What a great job on Brandon's hunting Kansas.
Yeah, they did a fantastic job.
Yeah, man, waxed the old hen with a beard.
Which you don't see very often.
No, man, I love it. I love it. So we jump right on into my hunt in Georgia.
Yeah, where you kill a big long spur bird.
Yeah, man, I think they're about an inch and a half spurs.
Yeah, that's a good bird.
Yeah, and one of them, Hooks, old Captain Hooks, what we call him, killed him in a field that Brandon East killed his first bird in. Tons and tons and tons of birds out there.
You and Brandon put some birds on the ground.
We got mad at him, man. We got mad at him. And he did a great job. What you guys don't see is you don't see him covered in ants. He kicked all the leaves back, and he's sitting there covered in ants while he's filming, and he don't move. And if y'all know Brandon, he'd normally be tripping.
He's antsy anyway.
But he did a great job, man. He did awesome. So there's no zoom because he has a camera up above him. And the way that the bird came in and everything. Y'all just check it out, man. It's a great hunt. It's a cool little different perspective on my best bird to date in Georgia. There just ain't no birds gobbling.
What Joe and Brandon don't know is their luck's about to change. They decide to head to the spot where Brandon killed his first bird. There, things heat up.
Dirt nap, full choke calls, ate up life. My boy Brandon East got it all on film. Hey, I mean, there ain't even no flop in here.
Ain't nothing in here.
I mean, he never did move another muscle, did he not? He has a rope. All right, 8 Up Nation, here we are. Had an absolute incredible morning again here in our home state here in Georgia. Got my boy Brandon Eads, brother from another mother, behind the camera today. And just last Saturday, opening Opening day, I called and got the pleasure to call in his first bird ever in the same field, literally probably with about 200 yards away, tops from each other. And but we know there's a lot of birds on this property, and they're everywhere. It's a good place. Very blessed to have it. But we also know that this dominant bird right here gave us a slip last year quite a bit. And man, he's been ruling the roost. I mean, he's just literally been keeping everybody lockjawed, scared to death. And we knew coming in here, we needed to get him out at all costs. And by gosh, we did it this morning. This joker right here is Captain Hook. His spur curls down. And it's unbelievable, man. What an absolute awesome time in the woods, in the turkey woods. And we just love this ate up life. And I wouldn't trade it for nothing. Y'all stay tuned for more action with Ate Up With It Outdoors TV.
Closed captioning for Ate Up With It Outdoors is brought to you by Frog Talks.
All right, well, you smashed that one, didn't you?
I did, man. That was a great hunt, great memory made. Probably my best bird in Georgia. Yeah, awesome spur on it, man, inch and a half spurs. And just a good hunt. I think it died a little bit of heart attack. It never flopped again,
never
man.
Never flopped, never wiggled.
Yep, so it was a good hunt. John Morgan had a good one, too, didn't he?
Yeah, he had a good one. He killed a bearded hen. He had a big tom come in on him first and missed it twice. So, a little broken hearted. We're sitting there and hanging out, and finally a couple more birds come in, and he finally gets the smash on a bearded hen.
He does, man. I think he... Are you serious right now, right in the middle of filming?
It's Hollywood. I can't help it.
Y'all check out this hunt with John Morgan while old Rodney over here answers his phone.
Might be Donnie.
April 23rd, Kentucky's turkey season, second weekend. I got the ground blind back up here on my grandmother's farm. And we're sitting over a clover patch, got alfalfa behind us. They've been out here strutting on this for the past couple weeks. We've got one goblin right over the ridge, just like always. So, I've got breeding hen and the Jake decoy sitting right over top of her. I go GoPro about 4 foot away from them, so cross our fingers. We can get one to come in there and pounce on that Jake. Get some good footage for y'all. Dismiss that bird. Too daggum close. You've got to be kidding me. All I got to say is Darren Rader has got a turkey gun. And patterns like a .22 rifle. I had that bird at 15 yards. I should have shot it when he was like 50. I hit him then. Still up here at the top of the ridge. We're just, I guess if we wait a little bit more time, maybe they'll come in. Guess we're in for a long haul. I thought we'd be able to go back and get some breakfast. Not today.
Thank you. that time, didn't it?
Give us a knuckle.
Oh, man. Got it done. First ever bearded hen. I've watched that hen for probably 3 years. And I promise you, I've took people back here to hunt. And she's came out 10, 15 yards. And nobody's ever wanted to shoot her. Every time I'm in the seat, she never would show up. Darren hit a couple hard cackles and some fighting bird real quick, and she was on. She came right on in here. She was hitting back to us. Before I knew it, she was right in here at 20 yards. She picked her head up, and I dusted her. So I can't wait to check her out, my first ever bearded hen.
April 23rd, second Saturday in the Kentucky turkey season here, and I have got my first bearded hen down. She don't look far off from the old avian. She come and was about 15 yards from the ground blind, and I dusted her. We went from the extreme up, down, then back up this morning. We had four toms across the ridge, top of the ridge, went out to the point, came back in here, got within 15 yards, and I missed one, just plain as day. And I thought the day was over. You know how it is, everybody, you know, we were down and out. Sure enough, Darren hit a call about 20 minutes later. She cut up and cut back at him. Next thing we know, she was popping out of the cedar thicket over here and heading right in here towards these decoys to hang out. She come in here and I gave her a headache. She's down here with us now, and I guarantee you she'll be some good eating.
Closed captioning for Ate Up With It Outdoors is brought to you by Frog Tops.
All right, guys, so another bearded head down.
Yep.
It's cool, man. It's real cool. We go right on from that into Ryan back in Kansas.
Yeah, that's how they finished their trip off.
Last day bird. And, you know, with all the traveling and stuff we do, man, and you go out there and you put all the time and energy and stuff in it, sometimes it don't all come together, you know, spectacular for footage purposes. But Ryan, he puts the reef on this joker.
Crawls through a muddy field to get to him.
Yeah, man. They worked their tail off. Brandon did a great job filming for what it was. And didn't quite get the primo shot on film and all that. But if you guys have ever reaped a bird, man, it's tough.
It's tough.
It really is.
Wide open.
Yes. And Kansas is wide open.
Wide open. Flat.
Brandon and Ryan, man, they get it done last day in Kansas. Y'all check out this next hunt.
Couldn't be any happier. This is the Jake I missed this morning with the bow. Made a couple calls, and about four hens came in and walked by us, and then came right back, and he was right behind them. Then he got to 70 yards, and I just couldn't get him with the bow to sling the OCD at him again. So Brandon had brought in a gun this morning as he was behind the camera, just in case we had enough toms come in, we could get a double off. I was like, Brandon, give me your gun. So I grabbed his gun and I started stalking these birds. And I mean, you want to talk about work. That was the hardest work I've ever put in for an animal. I was about to die crawling across this field, just filled with nothing but cow crap and everything else. But I mean, the good Lord blessed us today. We were able to get within 65 yards of this bird. And as you can see in the footage,
I shot and got him, but he tried to fly away, so I jumped up and started chasing him and shot him again. Couldn't be any happier, thanks to Brandon behind the camera and capturing it all. Thanks to Matt for having us out here with Lost Velvet in Kansas and putting us on some birds. Couldn't be any happier. Thanks, guys.
Well, I hope you guys enjoyed episode 5. We are rolling on.
We are, man. I think we're like 25 birds down.
Yeah, I got a lot more.
We got a lot more. Where are we going to be at next week?
Next week, we're going to Kentucky.
A lot of turkeys die in Kentucky, man, this year. So y'all make sure to tune in, 7 a.m. on Pursuit. Also, we're starting up Tuesdays on our Ate Up With It Outdoors page at 9 o'clock p.m. We'll be able to have the episodes up on our Facebook and with our links on Ate Up Nation on Instagram and on YouTube. So you guys check it out, plug in. Thanks for watching.